Do you want to set up Tailwind CSS inside the Vue application? Then let's commence this operation. Here I have a freshly created app with the CLI tool. So the first thing we need to do is to go to Tailwind CSS website and check out their documentation. Now I will copy the npm installation command. And now I will open a new terminal in VS Code. And I will paste the installation command and add the save dev property. Now we need to import the Tailwind styles, which are these three commands. And for this, we will need to create a style sheet for Tailwind. I will create a folder for CSS in my src path and paste the three Tailwind commands inside it. Now let's initialize the Tailwind config file. This will create a file in our root folder. We can see it right over here. This is where you can add your own styles, such as colors, margin and padding spaces, font sizes and family, and much, much more. As an example, I will replace the default Tailwind colors with my own color. Let's call this color awesome color and give it a random hex code. Since my setup is using postcss, I will use the commands in this section. So I will go to postcss.config.js and I will paste as instructed on their documentation. Now we will need to import the Tailwind stylesheet that we created in our Vue application. And to do that, we can just use the CSS import in our styling part of the main component. I will now run the npm serve command to build our application with a watcher, so that we can get updates through hot reloading. I will browse to localhost to see the application. Let me set my windows here. Remember that we have set a custom color in our Tailwind configuration file, which we called awesome color. Let's add a simple p tag in our HTML, which we can now see here thanks to hot reloading. I will now add some classes to our p tag, and this is where Tailwind comes in. TextXL will make our text size larger, and bg whatever color will give a background color according to the Tailwind config file. That's basically it. Now we have Tailwind in our Vue application. We managed to do it in just 2 minutes, so please like the video and subscribe if you haven't already. Happy coding and see you next time.